After a thrilling Spanish GP, riders were back to work on Monday at Circuito de Jerez Ángel Nieto for a one-day test in Andalucía. Some teams had plenty of homework to do ahead of the next round, so this is your roundup of everything we spotted in the south of Spain. Starting with Ducati, and after their success over the weekend during round 4, we saw the Bologna Bullets try out a new belly pan on Johan Zarco's Prima Pramac machine. It seems the new piece of kit is designed to help with cooling, as some inlets have been placed at the bottom to deal with airflow. For Spanish GP Victor Pecco Bagnaia, we didn't spot much new on his machine, as it seemed he worked mainly on new settings and some practice starts, while Davide Tardozzi admitted much of their focus was spent finding out why the world champion's bike struggled on Friday in Jerez. It was a big day for Honda as the Japanese brand continue in their quest to restore former glories, and they certainly had plenty of parts to try. The absence of Marc Marquez was a blow to HRC, but the four riders present on track had plenty to work on. Their experimentation with the Kalix chassis continued as Stefan Bradl and Joan Mir were spotted using it during the day, and despite Mir running into some technical problems while he was using it, team manager Alberto Puig confirmed the initial signs are promising. Mir also had an aero update which Bradl used throughout the weekend, while the Mallorcan also tried out the new downwash ducts on the RC213V, as did Rins. The LCR rider also tested a new and quite large winglet on the side of the swing arm. It's trying times at Yamaha as the Iwata factory desperately search for something to make their package a winning one. Both factory riders had two different chassis to ride with, while Franco Morbidelli went out with an aero that consisted of some bigger top and side pod wings. For Fabio Quartararo, he went out on a new exhaust in the afternoon, while it seems he is looking for something with the new swing arm that Yamaha have provided. He equipped both bikes on Monday with it, while he used this over the weekend, having previously shown a preference for the older one. It's been a very successful few days in Spain for KTM as they celebrated a double Sunday podium to add to their Saturday sprint success. For the test, they did have a few things to try. Dani Pedrosa returned to his day job after wildcarding in Jerez, and he tested out a new chassis. Sprint winner Brad Binder used the aero package that Pedrosa had during the week as he looked to find some more improvements aboard the RC16. And finally, with the Aprilia, it seems that they didn't bring much to test in Jerez, but that didn't stop Maverick Viñales and Aleix Espargaró from working on their race starts. Both riders have struggled getting good launches from the line recently, and it's clearly an area they're looking to improve in. They did also work on aero development, according to Paolo Bonora, in search of better performance and efficiency. That's a wrap on the 2023 Jerez test, as four busy days in the south of Spain come to a conclusion. Next up is a visit to the historic racing city of Le Mans for a historic 1000th Grand Prix. It's set to be an unmissable event, so make sure you tune in then.